Hello, this was originally going to be a fairly simple and straightforward video about one thing in particular, which I will show you in a moment. But things have got more complicated as I've been observing what's been happening with this whole Google Plus thing and the way people have been responding to it and the sort of ideas and perspectives on it that others have. So I'll start with what I was going to look at, and then I will develop it. If you look at this, you will see that, I mean, something I stumbled upon, that in my settings there was a button, a disabled button, for paid subscriptions to my channel. I have to have double the amount of subscribers that I have to enable it. So it's not going to happen, you know. It's taken me 7 years to get to 5,000 subscribers, so another 7 years and this place isn't going to possibly even exist, let alone look the way it does now. So it's not even an option for me. I wouldn't take it even if it was. But however, what I perceive that to be, because they quite often drop these little things in and they don't tell you about them, you just either stumble upon them or you don't, and they're very telling as to where the future is, they are planning to go in the future. And to me, this very clearly looks to be about turning YouTube into a subscription-only user base. So that, i.e. Netflix or one of these similar places. With a slight skew in that people who have got quite a few subscribers will be able to set themselves up as subscriber based channels as well. I mean, I certainly wouldn't, nothing personal to anybody, but I certainly wouldn't pay to view anybody. I'd go elsewhere. And I've long said that if they charged me a subscription for having a channel, I'd pay it, if it was reasonable. They could make millions, billions by doing that. It wouldn't have to be a great deal. I mean, Vimeo has a professional, a pro account, and it's not cheap, to be honest. I think it's a couple of hundred dollars a year, but they have far better facilities in terms of video qualities than YouTube does, and so on, and they have lots of groups and all sorts of things that YouTube doesn't have. Not that I think Vimeo is necessarily better, because there are lots of disadvantages as well. What I'm trying to say is that if I could pay monthly to have my channel, I would far rather go that way about it, but that's never been considered an option. Anyway, that's not the direction I want to go in. I've been a bit floppy, isn't perhaps quite the right word, but not as motivated, not as on the ball. I've had some difficulties in my personal life, and so you're not focusing on everything as clearly as you might otherwise, and I'm beginning to surface now and starting to see that maybe we need to do something about this. It may be a hiding to nothing, and we may not be cohesive enough to do it either, but let me try and suggest something. As a result of some of my friends out there, who you know who you are, who fed me various different bits of information about what's going on and how and why, there will be two links in the low bar to the Google kind of mission statement, which is absolutely hilarious considering what they actually do, and a link to their management team, which somebody suggested it would be a good idea to write on their Google Plus pages. Personally, I don't think it will, because they'll just get a sea of stuff that they won't bother with. I don't think that's the way to address it. Google does not listen to us. I think we already know that fairly comprehensively. However, another friend pointed out to me that they are not serving their customers well, because they consider their customers not to be us, but to be the businesses that put money in their coffers. So the people who use their search engine in a professional way, I mean, I've had them call up and ask me if I want to buy better space on their search engine. The businesses are their priority. That's who they think they're serving. That's who they want to please. However, they clearly haven't done any market research on the users or the people who buy the services of their businesses. So whilst we, you know, everyone bangs on about how helpless we are and how we can't do anything because then we don't matter to them and they don't care if we go to hell or disappear, and that we are a commodity, we are not, you know, and on it goes, you know, and they don't owe us anything, blah 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 blah. I mean, it's much more complicated than that in my opinion, but I'm not going to go into that here. But we do buy from the people that pay them, all of us, because we all use Google. We all use I think most of us at least use Google one way or another to buy services, and from other businesses, and the adverts that go up on our videos, whether we like it or not, are expecting to make money out of a respected, valuable service. But that's not what's happening. Their advertisers are having the mickey taken out of them, because their advertisers aren't being told about how they're treating their customers, i.e. us. So I have a thought. I suspect that we may not have enough cohesion between us, enough impetus, enough belief in the possibility that we can make the slightest difference, but it's still worth raising this as a possibility, that we make a compilation video and we make that abroad. You know, we spread this. We can do that now because we have Google Plus. So that we get some bigger channels, if at all possible. But even if it's not, we're all still customers. The bigger channel isn't a bigger customer of the businesses that buy their services from Google. We're all equal on that level. Well, I mean, obviously people who have more money are more likely to pay more into their... give them more, but that's, you know, it's a bit of a moot point. We make a compilation video which we then send to any of the businesses which use Google to boost their sales. And we may have to turn off our ad blocking software in order to achieve that for a bit, but it's easily enough done. Because I think if enough businesses become aware of the massive dissatisfaction and the way that YouTube users are being manipulated and taken advantage of and abused by the system and just treated like shit, basically, I think they may be wanting to question Google. So I think it might be more powerful to be telling these businesses about it than it might be to talk to Google, who really don't give two hoots what we think. So I don't know what you think about that. If you have any ideas, or if you think it's a good idea, if you think it's a crap idea, just, you know, let me know. I'm happy to. I'm probably not a big enough YouTuber to gather enough people to do this. But if you think it's a good idea, you can spread this, or if you know any bigger YouTubers who might be interested in doing this and who don't stand to lose through their Google income, because I think people like that may well not be interested, then, you know, let me know.